This week at the Internet Cafe, Soho Resources Online. If you run a small office or home office and need some advice, you might want to check out score.org. We'll show you why. This is Francie Ward. She runs a great website for small business owners called The Idea Cafe. If you run your business on the web, you need to advertise. LinkExchange.com will show you how. Meet Doug and Gail Cheeseman. They started a travel business at home, and they're using the web to grow their business. And if you're a woman starting off in business, check out iVillage.com. It's full of great ideas for the female entrepreneur. The best Soho resources on the web. This week at the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is brought to you by Z-Auction, the live online shopping experience. Additional funding from PC Connection and Mac Connection, the catalog and online superstore with PC and Mac products, toll-free technical support, and overnight delivery. And by Windows Magazine, delivering desktop, enterprise, and internet computing news, reviews, features, and how-tos for a Windows world, because the world runs on Windows. Additional funding from SoftSource Incorporated, publishers of Pro One Software, educational software for young adults.
Soho Sites on the Web. You guys work at home at all now? A home office?
I haven't yet, but I come from a real entrepreneurial family, and it's kind of one of my dreams is to set up my own business and work at home. So.
And you? What would you?
I actually have a home office. My challenge is that my home office is situated so that my window is right there, so I can see the garden, and I know how much work is out there. So it's really hard for me to balance. So.
Well, I have a home office. I do a lot of work at home now, and there, I think the web is really a potentially a great resource because you got all these questions. You don't have a lot of colleagues around. You don't have a water cooler. So I think it's going to be interesting to see what is available on the web for people who have a small office, home office, a Soho side of their lives. We'll find out.
Fred Thomas, you're with the score.org site, and let me see if I get this acronym right. It's the Service Corps of Retired Executives.
Okay. Exactly right.
I have to make a confession to you. I have an entrepreneurial bent. I would like to be an entrepreneur, but one of the things that scares me to death, obviously, is failing. And not being able to find the right people to, you know, counsel me and basically mentor me through that complicated process. Sounds like your organization is doing just
that's what we do.
Doing
that's,
just that.
That's our reason for existence.
Right. So tell me about SCORE. How did it start?
Well, SCORE is 34 years old at this point.
Long before the web.
Long before the web, which is now 10 months old,
right.
Just a newborn. We've been around. We've counseled like 3.5 million people in the time we've been here. We have 12,500 counselors who, like myself, are volunteers.
And these are retired executives?
Some are. Most are.
Who are successful in...
10% of our members probably are still working.
Okay.
90% are retired.
And are successful in business.
Yep.
And right. Are helping other people.
Volunteer their time to work with people like you.
Right. Sounds like a great organization. Now along comes the web.
Yeah.
And you've taken it online, and I understand you're doing counseling that way and helping people.
We are. We use the web three ways. We use it first, obviously, to publicize SCORE so more people know about it and use it. We use it to direct people physically so they'll be able to find out where our chapters are and get counseling there. And we use it to counsel people by email from the site itself.
So I imagine you've really expanded your scope. I mean, being able to reach people via email.
We're able to reach a lot of people now in remote areas that we weren't able to before.
Right.
We have clients in Alaska. We've got, I think, 35 or 40 different countries where people have come into the site looking for information.
Okay. Now, if I'm a new entrepreneur or someone who's running a business and I want that advice, I come to the site. Can I pick specific topics, or how do I hook up with
if
the right people?
You have to make a choice whether you want counseling face-to-face or counseling on the site. If you want it by email from the site, you go in and put in a couple of keywords. You're interested in starting a cyber cafe, so you'd put in cyber cafe and startup. And our little piece of software will then parse that, review the 350 counselors, pick those that are available and have that particular background, give you a choice of 3 to 5 of them to pick from, and you would then contact one of them directly by email from the site, and you'd be off and running.
Okay, now once I've set up this relationship and I started going, I imagine there's some differences, maybe even some difficulties compared to one-on-one counseling where two people are talking.
It's a little different. It takes a little longer to get to know the client by email. people understandably are a little more reluctant to reveal personal information. When I sit with you in an office counseling you, I ask you, you know, have you got any money in the bank to put into this business? People aren't going to tell me that over the net, at least not for the first month or so.
Or they could make their book sound better anyway.
So it's a little slower. The good part of it is the counselor and the client are both able to take more time in thinking about the questions and the answers that they want to explore with each other. So a counselor may spend a couple of hours getting ready for the next email session.
So there could be a stronger value.
If I'm doing it in the office with you, I might just be winging it and pulling stuff out of the file drawer.
Okay, Fred, well, when I go to start my business, I'm going to go check out score.org.
Do that. And if you don't want to do it by email, use our mapping software, and we'll show you where the nearest chapters are to your current address, and this map will come up, and you'll be able to knock on our door to chapter.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cmptv.com.
Some of the Soho sites on the web are deadly serious about money and finance and business problems and so on. One of them, though, is kind of fun. It's called the Idea Cafe. And Francie Ward, this was your brainstorm. Let me ask you about that sort of philosophy. You talk about a fun approach to serious business. What was the idea behind that?
Well, it's like, why not? Why does business information have to be so darn serious?
Right.
It doesn't. And if you can get the information across with a little bit of sugar, then it's much easier to take.
Sure, if you had a real job, right, people make jokes and they meet around the water cooler and they make fun of the boss and it's not all work, so you're trying to simulate that environment, I guess.
Yeah, and also owning a business is a really stressful thing.
Yeah.
So, but you've got to lighten up. You've got to manage that stress. So that's why we have things like yoga at your desk to
You know, what exactly is
up.
That? You actually have exercises for people to relax while they're there?
Yeah, like say, for example, this week the exercise is yoga to get in touch with your inner Elvis. Just shake loose a little bit.
All right, now you have an area where you can actually make paper airplanes. Is that another relaxation thing?
Absolutely. You know, it really sort of pierces a dull afternoon or a stressful one. We have biz paper airplanes. You can print out from your printer right now. We show you how to fold them up, and then you fly them, and I tell you, you will feel much better. I guarantee it.
Now some people might get a little odd. You have a business astrologer on your site?
Well, we have the biz horoscope.
Right.
After all, in business, you may want
who
to
knows?
Have... Yeah, hey, who knows where you're going to get the great business advice.
Now, one thing I really like on your site, one thing a small business person needs is to talk to other people who have similar problems. Mm-hmm. And you have Cyber Schmooze. Tell us about Cyber Schmooze.
Well, Cyber Schmooze is our meet and mingle area where business people can come, and if they have a question, they can lay it out there. Or if they can help somebody else with their question, then they can lend them a helping hand. It's very popular.
So you can't answer everybody's problems, and this way you can talk to other people. What are examples of a question somebody might ask in your Cyber Schmooze?
Well, like lately, someone told us that one of their employees is stealing from the company, but they don't know which one. How do they deal with this?
That? And did they get some good answers?
Oh, they got some great answers, because this is a very delicate situation, and it's certainly not something you can discuss with your employees.
Right.
Other questions are, what do you do about no-shows if you have the type of business that sets appointments?
Yeah.
Well, they drive you crazy, but you still want to keep them as customers.
Yeah. Now, one of the things I really like on your site is the fridge. I mean, that's such a great idea. I don't know whether that's sort of the woman's influence or not, but, you know, you're looking for stuff, and you're not sure where. You sort of just open up the fridge and look in there, and you have all that stuff laid out, just like the bottles inside your refrigerator. Where'd that idea come from?
Well, we have so much information on Idea Cafe, and we change it so often that this is our answer to archives. But like any fridge, every now and then we have to clean it out.
Some of the stuff gets stale there, yeah. Now let's talk about some of the serious things that are on your site. And there's some good, solid information. You have a great section on business communications. What's in there?
Well, in our biz communication zone, which is a good microcosm of Idea Cafe, I think, we have serious information. We tell people tips on dealing with your email. We show people how to scan pictures in to use as, say, a custom background to develop your brand identity and marketing.
How to make presentations.
Right.
You have a form section, which is great. Tell us about
that. Right. Well, we have a section on business forms where you can print out the form. But a lot of times people in small business, they don't even know what forms they should use or how to do it. So we tell them, we give them examples with characteristic Idea Cafe flavor, and then there's the form they can use.
Yeah. Well, it's called ideacafe.com. It's a great site. Thank you very much, Francie.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cmptv.com.
Liz, you're our resident expert on being a stay-at-home mom and balancing a home business, and you've recently written a book called
The Stay-at-Home Mom's Guide to Making Money.
And you also write a column, or a number of columns, actually, for Work From Home, which is a section of the iVillage website.
That's right.
Now tell me, I guess, first of all, what's iVillage all about?
iVillage is a women's network. It's like one of the most popular women's network right now online. And it's easy to see why it's so popular with its interactive services. You know, you've got the message boards, you have the chats, and the access to online experts such as myself in 9 different categories.
So what would be some of the other categories? I know we're talking about work from home, but there's a whole bunch of other things,
too. There's career, fitness and beauty, health, money, shopping.
All of your basics.
Yes.
Everything we worry about. Now, work from home, there's lots of different sections. I mean, there's a virtual cornucopia of things that you'd
Absolutely.
Find there, too. What would be sort of the key areas for
well,
that
Well, first
area?
You can go to starting out. That's a great place for just your basic questions. You're looking for a home business. What do I need to do? What do I need to look into? There's an area there that talks about scams, work-at-home scams. How do you know, if you read an ad, how do you know if it's going to be a work-at-home or a scam or not?
Right.
Another place you might look into is home runs. Mm-hmm. That's where you take, they've taken a business owner and interviewed them and their business, and they just, you know, what does it take to get you know to make your business work?
Right.
How much money? How much equipment?
So, for example, I mean, do I have some choices on the kind of businesses I could start up? I mean, are there sort of like the top, I don't know, good things to do from home?
Yeah, absolutely. Then there's hot home businesses, and that has it gives like a brief outline of the business, the skills you're going to need to run
right.
that business. Equipment and how much you can possibly make.
So now oftentimes, you know, we have a full-time job and we're thinking about, you know, wouldn't it be great? I've got kids and I want to work at home and do all these things. Is there sort of some information if you're thinking about transitioning into a new business and how to, you know, when do you know when to
start?
Right.
I hear that in chats all the time. You know, it's like, when is it time to me to quit the full-time job and go home? It's kind of a tricky little area there. And it's nice to be able to talk to other people who have done it and said,
right.
you know, this is when I found it, you know, to work for me.
So there's really that kind of information you get through the chat experience. Do you get
yeah.
it on the message boards as well?
Yeah, you know, it's nice on the message boards. You know, you can just post and come back later and read people's replies.
Now what about it? You know, you're a stay-at-home mom. You've got 2 toddlers at home, and the challenge is knowing when to shut the door and how do you balance home with life. I mean, I'm sure there's lots of things that you could share with people about how to manage it or how not to manage
right.
it.
Right. You can. I've written columns on that. You know, how do you balance your home business and your family life? You know, it's so important to take time for yourself, and sometimes people forget that, you know.
Right.
Usually you're the last on the list, you know, after the business, the family, the laundry.
Yep. And it's especially hard when you're doing actually work at home, is knowing actually when to turn the lights out
when
and say the business is over now and I can
absolutely
I can move on.
Another big issue is isolation.
Right.
You know, I mean, it's just you and maybe your kids or your pets. And it's so nice to be able to get on there and talk to other people. It's like I'm not the only one at home.
So being online is almost like the water cooler equivalent of,
yes.
of working at home, that type of thing. So now if I wanted to get access to work from home, how would I get to it?
On the internet, it's iVillage.com, and you can also find it on American Online at keyword iVillage.
That's great. And also your book is actually available through Amazon.com as well. So
that's right.
Lots of stuff to find out about starting your own business and working from home. Thanks a lot, Liz.
And we're here with Larry Magid, our resident internet expert here at the Internet Cafe. Larry, we're talking about SoHo websites today and small business, home businesses. A lot of them depend on the web these days. And there's a big mystery out there as to what the business model is. How do you make money on the web? And of course, you think of advertising, but that's even still a mystery.
Yeah.
We sort of know how radio and TV and newspapers work. What is the advertising business model on a website?
Well, it's the same principle. The more people you come get to your site, the more money you're going to get in advertising. The difference between newspapers and television radio is they can actually get an exact count
uh-huh.
of the number of people you come to your site, but the advertisers don't want you just to be at the site. They want you to click at their banner. So you measure click-through.
Right. So
you,
we hear about,
yeah.
let me ask, we hear about
yeah.
hits. We
right.
hear about page views. We hear about click-through. What's the difference in all those?
Well, the hits is actually kind of a meaningless number because it's the number of elements that get downloaded.
page views is very important because that shows how many pages that the viewer actually sees.
Actually looked at
very
on
important.
The site.
Click-through is an even more important number to many advertisers because that's actually the payoff. When somebody clicks on the banner and
actually
goes...
clicks on an ad banner and asks for information.
They go to the advertiser's site. That's really all a website can do is deliver that body. And so that's sort of the big payoff that a lot of advertisers want to see.
And now, if you're running a website and you want to go find advertisers, I mean, how do you begin to do that? Are there companies that do
yes,
this?
There are agencies that will link websites with advertisers. And it's actually a fairly simple formula. They pay you by the 1,000 visitors. And so once you establish a relationship, you need a certain number for it to make sense. A few thousand people a day, you're gonna have a chance to make some money. But the more people you get, the more chance you have to make money. It's a big mystery. A lot of people are trying to make money. It's not quite the gold rush that we all hoped it would be, but people are making some money on it.
All right, thank you, Larry.
My pleasure.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cmptv.com.
Now, Doug, you and Gail run an eco-tour business out of your home. And how long have you actually been in business?
Since 1980, our own company. We led trips for other people before that.
So you've been doing this for quite a long time. Now, all of a sudden, you decided to go online. You've got a web presence, a great website, lots of great pictures. What prompted you to go online?
I think just to the context and also to get a message out about, you know, what we do, the type of people we want to get, and get a conservation message out as well.
So tell me a little bit about Ecology Safari. What's your business all about?
You want to take that, Kim? So.
Well, we lead trips to Africa, Australia, Alaska, and then a few of the bee countries too, Brazil and Costa Rica. But on our website, we can put the entire itineraries, and it's wonderful because it also gives people who want to just see what we do a chance so they can read the itineraries without even having to call and ask for them.
That's right. So did it actually, going online, did it cut down the number of phone calls that you got? I mean, is it really
helping
answer those
things? No, in
fact,
it's enhanced that.
Really?
But I think at the same time, it cuts down a little bit on the paper we use. And being conservationists, we really like that.
Yeah, and I like your visuals, too. You've got some great pictures, great shots of birds and unusual animals that I wouldn't see every day on these tours, which really I think captures the essence of the tours that you're launching.
Right.
Now, what is it about going online? How has it changed your small business?
I think just the number of contacts, and we can cut back on our advertising, I think, in magazines, which is really nice because that's so expensive. And I think people get a better presence for us because an ad in some of the magazines, maybe an inch and a half by 2.5 inches, is $8.50 at one time crack. And that's
so it's
really
pretty expensive.
Very expensive. Online's been a lot less expensive. Plus, I think people get a better feeling for what they're seeing with the web. Much
There's
better feeling.
Depth.
Yeah, much
also,
more depth.
We can show our concern about what we care about.
So ecology issues. So, for example, you've got some concerns.
There's an entire section on Kenyan wildlife parks and the problems they're facing.
Yeah, and actually there's a lot of very good detail there for people who want to get more information, a lot of calls to actions, things that they can do as well.
And we have a son who's in grad school going to Duke University in conservation biology, and he's the one who actually writes our
website.
Does he?
He's
the one who
So it's a whole family operation that's going on.
In fact, his picture is on the web with his one-year-old daughter.
Oh, actually,
that time she's 1 month.
So now let me ask you. So from one end, what you're doing is you're advertising your business on the web. So it's sort of been a supplement or a substitute for magazine advertising. Are you actually doing booking your tours, conversing with some of your partners in some of the remote locations that you're running the safaris? Are you actually using it for communications as well?
Oh, definitely, because people can sign up. They can sign up. There's a page on the web where they can register for our safaris, or at least we
can sign up from someone in Japan through our website.
Yeah.
So you're actually getting a lot of more global customers participating.
Definitely.
So you actually have kind of a unique audience. It's fairly expensive tours that you're offering. I mean, a lot of very distance tours and a lot of expense associated with that. Are you finding most of your customers are online people?
A lot of them are. It's expensive, but what we do is not as expensive because the amount of time we spend in the field. A lot of people sign up for trips and there's a lot of fluff, and I'm not knocking that.
Right.
But our trips are definitely emphasizing being out in the field, looking at lots of wildlife, you know. It's not dancing and not gambling and that kind of thing. So it's a lot in the field.
So really specific kind of
in reality, we max time in the field. And I think that's how our trips are different. And that's what the web has allowed us to advertise, I think, more than just an ad in a magazine. You know, we can really push that. And then also the conservation, which Gail mentioned.
So what's next for the website? Are you planning to expand a little bit? I mean, is the whole idea to grow your business or is it to keep it nice and tight.
I think.
Keep it small.
Yeah, our emphasis really is to keep it small. We want to keep really good quality control. And the web will probably expand, but I think we're going to keep it to about 10 trips a year where we lead 7. And then the other 3, we have some good friends who have led them for us. But we like to keep our fingers on the pulse,
right,
you know, and keep it in control.
Well, it's a great site, and I wish you all the best with these tours. Some really exciting ones coming up for the millennium, too.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cnptv.com.
Tony and Sanjay, you're from Link Exchange, and as I understand it, it's a banner ad network on the web, a way to help people advertise their small businesses. Now, I hear you guys started this kind of on a whim. You had another business actually going, a pizza business. How did this all get going?
Sanjay and I actually met in college. We were roommates pretty much all 4 years there, and we ran a pizza business together. And from that, we learned that we...
Not out of your dorm room, I take it.
It was actually out of our dorm room, sort of, and we used some of the space downstairs as well. But we found that we worked well together, and we also discovered that we wanted to run some sort of business after graduating.
Okay.
After graduating, we started a web design business together, and we had a lot of local clients, like the local chamber of commerce, mall, hotel, and so on. But what we found was, after creating these websites for them, there really was no good way for them to get exposure on the web. Mm-hmm. They couldn't participate in banner advertising because they didn't have, you know, $5,000 a month to spend with Yahoo or any of the other big sites.
Right, and it is expensive. I mean, there's, just as in the print world or television world, there are sort of premium places that you'd like to advertise, but they cost a lot.
Right.
So what's this idea, Sanjay, that you guys came up with?
Okay, well, Link Exchange is basically a cooperative advertising network. What that means is members of the network show ads for each other.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a great way to get exposure on the internet without having to pay any money. And we run the largest cooperative advertising network on the web.
Okay.
So just
come
to us.
And then I take it you guys make a little money on the side from some of the extra.
We reserve a piece of the inventory, and then we can sell that.
Okay. How many advertisers do you currently have? I hear you're the largest network on the web here. So.
Yeah, it's actually over 200,000
wow.
members in the network right now.
That's
it's growing. So
that's
it's
a big
pretty
group.
Exciting.
Okay. So how do these folks come to you and get a good targeted campaign that, you know, sometimes could be kind of an obscure business, a cookie business or
right.
you know, something like that? What do you do?
Pretty easy. They just come to our site, linkexchange.com, sign up online, and you can actually choose online which categories you'd like to target.
Mm-hmm.
So you can be as specific as Major League Baseball if your site's about that,
mm-hmm.
or even more narrow.
Mm-hmm.
In addition, there's categories, there's ratings. So
mm-hmm.
if you have a children's site, you don't want to show it.
So you want to make sure you can filter out pornography, adult sites, or things like
absolutely.
That.
Absolutely. In fact, there aren't any X-rated sites
really?
In the network.
So that's a sort of a rule that you said we're going to maintain that. Okay. Now, what about things like other countries or languages?
Yeah, we actually have a number of different languages, about
mm-hmm.
30 or so.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want to target Portuguese sites, you can do that as well.
Right. What kind of success are people having with this so far? I mean, is this really a major way for people to promote their businesses? Are they finding good click-through, good traffic from this type of stuff?
Definitely. I think the main thing that our members appreciate is getting the exposure that just isn't possible in any other way.
Mm-hmm.
And on top of that, the exposure they're getting is for free. And it's done in a cooperative fashion. So what we've really got is a nice large community of 200,000 website owners. And everyone, kind of in the spirit of helping each other out. So if you go to our website at www.linkexchange.com, you'll also find a lot of other resources for small businesses and website owners. For example, we have a mailing list that goes out every weekday,
mm-hmm.
and it's just about website owners giving tips to other website owners. Maybe they're starting out, or maybe they've experienced something and they want to help other website owners or small businesses.
Right,
so
as well. Okay, well, I'll tell you what. I'm going to brainstorm, think of my business, and I'm going to give you guys a call.
So, Andrew, did you discover anything that would make it more likely for you to start that little business at home?
I think so. I would like to start a web-based business.
Okay.
I have some fantasies about doing that. And Link Exchange was a great way to really go out and promote your site, fairly inexpensively. It costs a lot to buy these
right.
kind of ads. and here's something that was nice for that. Also, the retired executives, you know,
able
offering
wise
some
advice,
counseling.
Not
yeah,
out there on your own.
Yeah. No, it's great to be able to get that sort of resource and yeah. that sort of knowledge. So,
what did you learn, Jane?
I like the work from home site. I think that was great for women trying to balance family with their career mm-hmm. in their houses. And the best part was that area that taught me how to set up my home office because I
just
still haven't perfected
stuff.
It. Yeah, yeah, I got a ways to go yet.
Well, I think what's interesting about working at home and home offices is people do miss that social contact at work.
Definitely.
The kibitzing around the water cooler and the just talking and trading ideas, which can be very, very valuable. IdeaCafe.com, the site I looked at, really helps you do that because it lets you talk to people and so on. So there are a lot of good ideas out there. That's it for this week at CyberSmith. We'll see you here next time at the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is brought to you by Z-Auction, the live online shopping experience. Additional funding from PC Connection and Mac Connection, the catalog and online superstore with PC and Mac products, toll-free technical support, and overnight delivery. And by Windows Magazine, delivering desktop, enterprise, and internet computing news, reviews, features, and how-tos for a Windows world, because the world runs on Windows. Additional funding from SoftSource Incorporated, publishers of Pro One Software, educational software for young adults. To purchase a videotape copy of today's program, call toll-free 1-888-310-7850. Please specify the show number and the topic.